Some people were born into wealth, connections, and privilege. My story is not one of those stories. Perhaps yours isn't either. So let's explore that topic today.
I'd made that intro as a way to dramatically set up what I'm about to show you now. And it's how I grew up and how it formed how I now think. Now this photo here is a photo of me as a boy. And I'm going to read you the Facebook post that I posted behind this. So here we go. This is me as a young boy going to the bathroom in the only bathroom we had. There's a notion in psychology called the overprediction of fear, which is that most of us overestimate just how terrifying certain experiences will be. I grew up quite poor. We didn't have an indoor bathroom. We had this outhouse. But I didn't know we were poor. I was always loved, read to constantly, taken for walks, and taught that I could become whatever I set my mind to. I'd hang out with my pet raccoons. Now that's true, we found them in a woodshed in the backyard, and then the mom and the babies sort of took to us because we'd feed them. I'd journey through the northern Wisconsin woods, ride my bike, and read. Since my mother had to work 2 to 3 jobs, my grandma and grandpa took on the task of doing much of the raising of me. My grandpa read constantly, so it became a lifelong habit of mine. I'd escape into books to learn about worlds vastly different from my own. Later, since I lacked social skills, I'd use books to escape having to talk to people. I realized early that people tend to not bother a kid who is reading. Still true to this day. All of this was a perfect way to be raised from my perspective. As I grew, I was never as fearful of the situations that many kids were, and now many adults are. I know what it's like to be poor, and I also now know what it's like to lose money after having had money now as well. It wasn't a big deal. I know what it's like to be alone, to be cold, and to learn how to handle situations on my own. Because of a lack of fear of typical societal issues, I'm now allowed free range to try unusual ideas, because I'm not afraid of the consequences of failure. It's just not that bad. I hope you enjoyed that. It got a nice reaction when I posted it to my Facebook wall, so I'll post it in the description if you'd like to see it. And any of you who are feeling like you started low and you're trying to get to a station in life, I would like to know you. As long as you have some gumption, some heart, a fire in your belly, if you want to raise up, there's always people who are higher up the ladder than you that want to help you, that want to help raise you up, because they see themselves in you and want to make sure that you get where you should go in life. So Mallory and I are out for a run and she's stopping to get a Gatorade. But when we were going through the marsh, she dropped her Ray-Bans, and so you'll see that here. Here she comes. I have some questions for her. It seems like you could climb down that railing pretty well, like you used to burgle in your day.
I burgle all the time.
Like you're a burglar.
All the time.
You used to be a burglar. You're guilty, aren't you? Okay, so today I thought, you saw the intro to the vlog already, right?
Heard it.
Yeah, so essentially I'm going to talk about the fact that, you know, when you grow up poor instead of rich, you get used to being poor, so you're not afraid of it because you could easily go back to it. Like me, I'm not afraid of being poor again, but there's things I'm not afraid of skydiving or bungee jumping or any thrill rides. But like snakes, you know me, I don't.
I'm afraid of skydiving and bungee jumping and all thrill rides.
What about
but
snakes?
I mean, not what? So much.
We
if it was like trying to eat me, then yes. But not if we went for a walk and saw a little garter snake.
We did see one the other day.
I wouldn't immediately flip and say we have to leave and get off the trail.
Who would do that?
You did. You got afraid of a baby snake.
No, I didn't.
And then we had to leave.
I'm going
to
cut that out of the vlog. It was like this long.
But it was curled up and hissing. It was the hissing that got me.
Did you even see it? And it wasn't hissing.
I don't know. In my mind, it's there.
It's incapable of hissing, I'm pretty sure.
Whatever. I've heard it hiss. What's the worst way you'd want to die? People say drowning, but I wouldn't want to die burning.
That's not
burning.
Something I would ever want to think about. I haven't put a lot of thought into it.
Well, you're getting your scuba license.
It would be like Dexter murdering me would be my...
Oh, yeah. There's our thing. Good.
Did you get us that artichoke too?
Yep, we did. Thank you.
Thank you.
Pretty hot.
Perfect.
Yummy. It was...
fantastic. You know what I'm not scared of is eating tons of artichoke dip.
It was artichoke, red pepper, and something, not just spinach and artichoke like normal.
It looks amazing.
Do you want a plate?
No. Can't wait for the X Games tomorrow.
Because I didn't go to work.
Okay. Now imagine tomorrow when we're watching the freestyle motocross.
I have an eyelash.
That's something that would scare a lot of people. Doing double backflip?
Do
oh, you
My
would?
My dad, he didn't do double backflips, but he raced dirt bikes when he was young, and he crashed and he had to have surgery, so he's always had this huge scar on his shoulder.
I'm going to ask him about that tomorrow. I'm glad he's going.
I think a lot of people are going to go, though it is Rockfest, so that will cut some.
Mitch Newman's probably going to be there. I'll hit up some people tomorrow.
Do you like this better than the last artichoke that we had?
I don't know. I love that last one, but this one is spicy. So I really like it. I don't know. Artichoke dip for me, I just love this stuff so much. However it's made is good. Another cheers. Miller Lite.
I just ordered a Corona because... Oh my god, nice and